Hello people, welcome back, Watch Wizard here. I hope all of you are doing great. Today I am going to work on this replica watch. It is powered by an Chinese automatic movement, DG2813. This movement is a replica of Miyota caliber 8200. Here I was releasing the stored energy in mainspring through ratchet click. Now I will remove the balance upper jewel. To remove it, we have to unlock the shock first. This is called pallet fork bridge, and this is pallet fork. Now I will remove the train wheel bridge. In this moment, all the wheels are under this bridge. Reduction wheel, ball winding wheel, ratchet wheel and barrel complete. Fourth wheel, third wheel, sweep second pinion and escape wheel. And this is crown wheel. This lock is called day guard and this is day calendar. Below it there will be some wheels and from there we can access the keyless section. This is called date guard. Date calendar, date jumper, calendar character lever, I don't know what is the name of this wheel. Minute wheel. Date driving wheel. Now I will remove the keyless section. First we will start with SLS. There is a guard for yoke. yoke. There is a spring for yoke. Setting lever. And that was the clutch wheel. Now I will remove the lower balance jewel. To remove the cannon pinion, I have used a pin vise. And this is the center wheel. This is the barrel complete, and in there is a mainspring and arbor. After cleaning the barrel and mainspring, I have applied a small amount of oil on the mainspring. And some oil over here for center wheel and complete barrel. Some oil for center wheel bridge. I don't think there is a need to remove this movement ratchet click. This is Paul winding wheel. And this is reduction wheel. Small amount of oil for crown wheel, but it would be great if we use grease. And some oil for sweep second pinion. Training this movement wheels is quite tricky. First, we have to put both of these screws in their respective position and leave them little bit loose. We will start aligning the wheels from third wheel. Once we get the third wheel upper pinion in its respective jewel, we will try to get reduction and Paul winding wheels pinions in their respective jewels. Once they are in, we can move on fourth wheel and escape wheel. This way we can easily train this movement wheels.